folks, this is Mr. TARDIS, and I have only recently, like, reset my webcam, and it looks way too bright. That's a lot of bloom. Let me try and fix this. Okay, that looks a little better. Okay, I think we're there. Well, I don't know. I'll have to properly... I just plugged the webcam in, and after using my normal one, and I think it's messed up my settings. So, folks, no live stream this Monday night. We're going to be doing the live stream tomorrow night instead. So that's Tuesday, the 21st of September at 7:30 p.m. British summer time. So be there for that. We're going to be talking about how we found the Doctor. We've got the 11th Doctor Chronicles from Big Finish and loads more to talk about. Be there for it tomorrow night. I've also got my next big Doctor Who review done. However, I'm going to save that for the end. We're going to talk about that at the end because I wanted to give you folks a little update just as what's happening with the Mr. TARDIS channel right now. So I've been a little bit hesitant to start any big projects because I have no idea when Series 13 is dropping. One could drop between me recording this and me uploading it, but we don't have a release date now. We've got no air date or anything. I think it might come, as in the release date, might come next Sunday when the last episode of Vigil airs. So that's kind of my next guess, but I'm not placing money on that. I'm not making a bet on it because that backfired last time. However, I can't 100% guarantee it now, but I will say that the next December project after Dalek-cember, after Cyber-cember, is in production. I don't know if it'll get across the finish line in time. I've made it deliberately a much smaller stakes, smaller scale project, just in case I'm not able to finally get it done in time. But however, I am working very hard on that this next week, the week after. So hopefully you will get December festive Doctor Who themed content from December 1st to December 25th in another advent calendar. However, let's talk about the recent format change where I've been doing these live streams and then over the course of the week, I upload segments from the live streams. I understand that quite a lot of you watch just the live streams and there's no point in watching the re-uploads because you've already seen the live stream and that's absolutely fine. But there's also people out there who don't want to watch a two-ish hour live stream to get to all of the bits that they want to hear. And so we'll watch the re-uploaded version. I completely don't understand that. That's just basically giving you folks choice. But also, and slightly selfishly, it means that I can keep content going on the channel, and YouTube is massively appreciating it. All of my, like, numbers and statistics and everything from the YouTube analytics are like... which has also resulted in quite a good influx of new subscribers. So, hey folks, this is Mr. TARDIS here. Thank you so much, we're nearly at 21,000 subscribers, so hello. However, the issues are still persisting with like YouTube's algorithm and the analytics and stuff like that, where I have like over 20,000 subscribers, but only about 1,000 people are getting notified whenever I upload a new video. It's kind of messed up. But let's work with the cards that we've been dealt, which is why I've been doing the live streams and then uploading the segments. The live streams are just a genuine highlight for the week. I can't wait for tomorrow's one. We're going to be talking about so much. Be sure to tune in live. But when Series 13 comes out in the near future, hopefully that will have started and happened while I'm waiting for the December marathon to get out of copyright dispute. So it means I can keep content going. I'm also wanting to do more like non-live stream related, like semi-unscripted, semi-edited videos, kind of like my recent response video to Nerdrotic and Yellow Flash, like my recent Noel Clark and John Barrowman videos. Hopefully non-serious subjects or non-antagonistic subjects, but we'll see how that goes. I want to do kind of more editorial stuff like that. I want to also try and do more countdowns. I want to try and do more just general standalone reviews that aren't tied to a marathon or a series. And also, let's see what the future holds for the Trip of a Lifetime Series 2, if that does happen. I do think the format needs changing for the Trip of a Lifetime, though. I think kind of like the lead-in interlude before getting to the review proper. I actually think that that kind of negatively impacted the series. And I think that unless I'm doing like regular daily uploads, YouTube just does not give a shit in terms of actually promoting or spreading the videos. That's why Dalek-cember and Cyber-cember, they did so well. But then I do the Trip of a Lifetime, which is meant to be sort of like a placeholder marathon, and then YouTube just completely buried it. I also think it might have been to do with the subject matter. I think maybe people who watch my channel wanted my opinion on stories that they'd never seen before or stories that they'd only heard about. Whereas when it comes to Doctor Who Series 1, I've already reviewed them. People already know my opinions on them. And also people have obviously already seen those episodes numerous times. Maybe they didn't think there was much more I could bring bring to the table, and that's fair enough. So hopefully we'll do the Trip of a Lifetime series 2, we'll mix up the format a little bit, we'll see how things go. Also, one oft-requested thing is Big Finish Friday, which I've kind of sort of pseudo been doing with the livestream segments. I try to upload the Big Finish segments on a Friday to sort of keep that mini tradition that I don't think anyone but me and a handful of other people care about, but I appreciate the commitment. But in terms of an actual proper Big Finish segment, I've had like scripted reviews like ready to go for like a year, as in like they're not made, but I've scripted them and written them and everything. They're kind of been ready to go for about a year, I guess haven't got around to it, and I want a really good backlog so I don't wind up catching up with myself when I haven't got enough like stuff ready to re-record again. Oh, and two more things, and possibly the two most important things of all. One, my cat snuck into the room while I wasn't looking. Hi Theo, come here, come on. That's all right. You got up there, you can get down again. Come on, through the pumpkin patch. All right, I'll help him down. Oh, you did it. Come on. Up you come. And possibly the most important thing of all, myself and my wife, we still do a podcast. We still do the Monster Monday podcast, which is a semi-weekly horror film podcast. We're just trying to get our schedules aligned at the moment. We've both been very, very busy, but we are still trying to record new episodes, try and do them every week or every other week. So be sure to subscribe to those. Monster Monday podcast, Monster Monday. We are on Stitcher, we are on iTunes, we're on Anchor, we're on Spotify. Check us out there. You folks probably want to know what's happening with the next big review. Well, folks, the next big review that I'm doing is, and I thought I had it here, I've left it on the shelf, bam, The Web of Fear. I've done a review of The Web of Fear. It is now available to all of my patrons. You should have had a link a couple of hours ago, a private link where you're able to watch The Web of Fear, my review of The Web of Fear, I should say. This isn't piracy. I've not uploaded the whole of The Web of Fear. So The Web of Fear has been sent to all of my patrons. There is a link to the patron post down below, which you can only access if you are a patron, so I would massively appreciate all of the support if you want to become a patron. But if you do not want to become a patron, that's absolutely fine. But because of YouTube and the BBC's like copyright stuff, it means that you won't be able to watch the review for about 2 months, which is depressing. But the 60-day time limit that the BBC seem to deliberately enforce, that's something beyond my control. This is kind of the best way I can sort of make it work. So yeah, The Web of Fear is the next review. The live streams are going to keep on going. We're going to move back to Wednesdays in like a month's time, but you know, obviously keep an eye on my social media feeds for updates. I don't really use Facebook anymore. I just don't really use Facebook generally, even like personally, just hardly ever use it. I'm way more active on Twitter, so follow me at Trilby Reviews. And that's kind of really the only social media that I'm on. So yeah, follow me on Twitter. It's the place to be and the place to argue and get political and blah. So folks, I hope you're having a fantastic September. I will hopefully see you once again in the near future, whether it's on a live stream or in another video. Either way, I appreciate all of the support as always. Love you all. See you folks next time.